In this video, I explain the site selections of thermal power plants. So in a last video, we understand about the component as well as the layout of this thermal power plants. Okay. So from that video, you can understand few of the important points they are required for the site selections. So here in this diagram, you see that the first thing, coal is required. Okay. So we are required availability of the coal, means first point for the site selection is the availability of coal. Second point, in the boiler we supplied the water and it is converted into the steam, means availability of water is also important points. Third point, that is the availability of labor, means to operate these thermal power plants we are required a skill as well as the unskilled labor. Fourth point, that is the ash disposal facilities. So here you see from the boiler the ash is coming. For that ash we are required a proper disposal facilities, for that we are also required a land. Okay. For installing the land, for the staff, we are required the land requirements. Okay. So next point is the requirement of the land. And suppose this land is available, then the which type of the land is available, means nature of land is also important, because these lands are required to absorb the static as well as the dynamic load, because these here turbines are rotating at the very high speeds. Okay. So lands are able to sustain the forces of the turbines. Another is the transportation facilities. Transportation facilities is required for installing the plant, means we need to supply this machinery to that locations. After starting the plant, we are required the transportation facilities for the labor. Okay. And they are create some public problems, so we need to avoid the, or we need to install the plant from the away from the public and for the future extension. So these are the various points. Okay. Now we are discussing these points in the detail. Okay. So first point is the availability of a coal. So in availability of coal, the modern coal based steam power plants require a huge quantity of coal per year. Okay. So coal based power plant is required very huge quantity of coal per year. A rough idea, a thermal power plant of 100 megawatt capacity required 1200 to 1500 tons of coal per day. Okay, so this data is for day. Okay, that is a 100 megawatt plant is there, then we require 1200 to 1500 ton. 1 ton means 1000 kg. Okay, so this requirement is per day. Suppose we multiplied with 365 days, so in a 1 year we required a very large quantity of coal. Okay, hence, plant consuming such a large quantity of coal should be located as far as possible near the coal miners, in order to save the coal transportation cost. Okay. Means to avoid the transportation cost, we install the thermal power plant near to the coal mines, then we are able to reduce the coal transportation cost. Okay. So it is every time it is not possible that we can install the thermal power plant to the coal mines. Okay. Because we also consider to the load centers. Okay. So load center is also one point for the site selections. So if you combine all the points, then you can think about the which factors are most important. Also, if plant is located away from coal mines, it may be create problems due to failure of transportation systems or a strike at mines. Okay. So suppose we install the thermal power plant away from the coal mines, then which types of the problem is coming? So failure of transportations. Okay. Suppose this railway line is stopped due to these heavy rains, suppose due to the strikes, then create a lots of problems. Okay. For these reasons, considerable amount of coal, at least 15 day coal supply must be stored at the power stations. Okay. Means we need to store the 15 day requirement of coal as a storage. Okay. Means suppose 1 day we require 1500. Okay. Then we need to store the coal for 15 day. Means 1500 ton into 15. Okay. However, it increases the space requirement. Means suppose we are going to store the coal for the 15 day, it's increase the space requirement. Okay. They also increase the staff cost and losses of coal storage. In case it is not possible to locate the plant near the coal mines, then the plant shall be connected to the railway. Okay. Means we need to select such a sites which are near to the coal mines or they are connected with the railway. Now, second point is the availability of water. So in a thermal power plant, you see the in a boiler we supply this water and it is converted in steam. Means water is the main substance. Okay, coal is also the main substance. And the water is also required for the cooling in the condenser. Even in a cooling towers, the waters are required. Okay. So in the steam power plant, water and steam is working fluids. Hence, large quantity of feed or makeup water is required. Also, huge amount of water for condensers and for disposal of S. So here this water word is there. Okay. This word is the water. Means huge quantity of water is required for convert into the steam. Even the water is required in a condenser for the cooling. Even water is required for the disposal of S. A rough idea, a thermal power plant of 100 megawatt capacity, then 3000 to 50,000 tons cooling water required per hours. Okay. 30,000 to 50,000 tons cooling waters are required per hour. These are the very big digit is that. If the cooling tower is used, means we are use the closed system for the cooling waters. Okay. At that time we need to use the cooling tower. And if the cooling tower is used, then 800 to 1000 ton cooling water required per hours. Okay. So this data is for the open cycles. Suppose we use the cooling tower, then this requirement is reduced to 800 to 1000 tons. The makeup water required to compensate the loss of feed water is also 10 to 15 ton per hours. Okay. So you already know what is the makeup waters. Further, the water must be pure as possible to reduce the cost of water treatment for the feed waters. Okay. So in layout, we also studied that the water treatment plant is required. Okay. So if the water is pure at that particular location, then we are not required the water treatment plant. Okay. If the water is not pure, it have lots of impurities, then we need to install the water treatment plants. Therefore, by selecting the site for a steam power plants, above factor must be considered carefully. It is therefore necessary locate the plant near the water source, which will be able to supply required quantity of water throughout the years. So generally you see that the number of power plant is installed near the river. Okay. So this is the one of these reasons why this thermal power plant is installed near the rivers. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to power plant engineering and other subject of this mechanical engineering. For more video, I request to visit the playlist. Also, the various link is provided in descriptions as well as in a card. Next point is the S disposal facilities. S is the main waste produce of a steam power plant. Means S is the main waste product of a steam power plant. The S handling problem is more serious than the coal handling. So for the coal handling, we are also required the few of the system like as the conveyors. For the S handling is also difficult than the coal handling plants, particularly in India, because in India coal available having a large percentage of S as a 20 to 40%. Okay. Means suppose we have a 100 kg of coal, okay, and we burn it, then the 20 to 40 kg S is produced. Okay. So these percentage are very large. Okay. Because S comes out in a hot condition and it is highly corrosive. Okay. And the S handling problems are more difficult because they are come in a hot conditions. Okay. And we need to remove it the hot state. When the coal handling is easy because the coal is in the normal atmosphere temperatures. Its effect on the atmospheric pollutions are more serious and human health is concerned. Okay. So they are create the pollution. Means suppose the S is supplied with this atmosphere, that is a fly S is also there. Okay. So fly S is dangerous for the human health. A 100 megawatt steam power plant produce approximately 350 to 500 tons S per day. Okay. So if you can calculate in a first slide, we study about the availability of coal. Okay. In that topic, what we discuss, 1200 to 1500 ton of coal is required per hours, okay, or a per day, sorry, it is a per day, okay. So here you see this data of this coal, okay, in the first slides, we mentioned that the 1200 to 1500 ton of coils per day is required, okay. So these things are multiplied with 20 to 50%, then what digit we get? We get it is a 350 to 500 tons per day S is remove. Okay, so these things are, these data are very big, so this create the lots of problems. It requires 2.5 hectare area per year if the S is dumped to a height of 6.5 meters. Okay, so 1 meter is equal to near to 3.3 foot. Okay, so 6.5 means suppose we dump the coil to a 20 foot, then they are required 2.5 hectares of area per year for dumping a S. If the site is near the coal mine, it can be dumped into a discus mines. In a case of site located near the river, sea or a lake, S can be dumped into it. Presently, S from the power station is used for the many industrial process and the brick making for a construction works. Okay, so earlier what happened is S is supplied to this river. As earlier I discussed, these plant are installed near the rivers. Okay, so what they are doing, they are dispose the S into the rivers. Okay, but nowadays this S is used for the different industrial process as well as for use in a construction sites for bricks. Okay, so bricks are also made from the S, and the brick made from the S is very light in the weight compared to the other bricks. Next point is the land requirement. Okay, why this land is required? Land required not only for setting up the plant, but for the other purpose such as a staff colony, coal storage and S disposal. Okay, so for coal storage and the S disposal, very large space is required compared to this plant setup. Okay, for 100 megawatt plant, the land requirement may be 300 to 500 acres. As the cost of land add up to the final cost of the plant and it shall be available at reasonable price. Means we need to select the location such a way that the price of the lands are lower. Land shall be also available for future extension. Suppose we have the capacity of the 500 megawatts. And after 10 years, we have planned to extend it for the 500 megawatt to 1000 megawatts. Okay. So we need to select the location such a way that we achieve the land for the future expansions. Now, the next point is the nature of land. Okay. So last point is the land requirements. So after land requirement, which types of the land is available? That is also the important point. That is the nature of land. The type of land to be selected should have good bearing capacity, as it has to withstand not only the dead load of the plant but also the force transmitted to the foundations due to the operations of heavy machinery of a plant. Means the land should be able to sustain or transmit the dynamic forces. The minimum bearing capacity of the land should be 1 into 10 raised to 6 Newton per meter square. That means suppose we have the 1 meter square land, okay, and this land we are applied to force, that is a 10 raised to 6 newtons, then land should be able to absorb it. Next point is the load centers. Load center means it is the distance between the power plant and the electricity supply. It is called as the load centers. Okay, so side of power plant should be as near as possible to the load, so that the transmission cost and losses are minimum. Okay, I mean suppose this electricity is produced in the Surat and direct transport to the Goa, means that are the very long distances there. Okay, so it is better to install the plant in the Goa or near to the Pune or Kolhapur or Mumbai. That is a big thing. That means we need to reduce the distance between the locations of producing electricity and the location transporting the electricity. It is called as the load centers. And these distances are near possible, then the transmission cost and the losses are minimum. Because when we transport the electricity, we require the very high transmission lines. And in a transmission line is longer, then the number of losses are increases. However, a plant cannot be located near all the loads. Okay, suppose it is not possible to locate the plant near all the loads. So in that case, what we do, we can find out the CG of the load. In center of location is find out of this total load of this plant capacity. Okay, so in this case the CG of the load is determined with reference to the two arbitrary chosen axes, and this CG is known as the load centers. Hence, in order to minimize the cost and the losses, the plants will be located as far as possible near to the load centers. Okay, means plants will be installed near to the load centers. Next point is the transport facilities. The power plant should be near the railway line for bringing the heavy machinery for installations and for bringing the coal. Next point is the availability of labor. At the time of construction of plant, enough labor is required. Hence, there should be a skilled and unskilled labor available at reasonable rates near the sites of the plant. Next point is the size of the plant. In case of small power plant, cost of transmission line is relatively high, hence it should be near to the load center. Means suppose the capacity of the plant is lower, then we need to install near to the load centers. Okay, because the transmission line is the relatively high cost, because the capacity of the plant is lower, means we are producing low electricity and transporting to the large distance, then the cost is very high. But in a case of large power plant, the cost of transportation of coal, cost of waters are relatively high compared to the cost of transmission lines. Hence, the power plant should be near the coal mines as well as the water source. Okay, means when we installing the power plant have a very large capacity, at that time we need to focus that the plant should near the coal mines or a water source. Okay, so at that times we can put the very long transmission lines, then the cost of transmission line is very low compared to the coal as well as the water source. Next point is the public problems. Site selected should not any sort of nuisance to the neighboring area due to emissions of smoke, noise and the water vapors. Hence, plant should be located far away from the towns. Means we need to locate the plant away from the cities or the away from the villages. Next point is the future extensions. The choice of the site should allow for economical extension with the estimated growth of load. A site selected may not necessarily satisfy all the factors mentioned above. Means it is not possible to satisfy these all the points we study. But however, a suitable compromise must be made between the major factors. Okay, so we need to satisfied few of the factors according to these small power plants or a large power plants. Okay, so we need to find out which things are economicals, then we can decide. Okay, this point is not satisfying. Okay, they are not increasing our cost. So that's why we need to find out the base side for the thermal power plant. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels and share with your friends.